Entering the little palace requires keeping her quiet. And growing something up would likely fail.
Well, she'll take an edge.
You should.
I go to Helene now and ask for her buyout. She knows I need an edge and sets a price I can't pay. Imagine it. It's what I would do. Besides, an edge refuses to kill.
Well, I've just done so far, and I'm still alive, so yeah, once is on anyone's side. That's why I brought you.
No.
Make sure they don't see me.
You're gonna create a diversion? I love his music theme, you know? Cause. Is the guy you're supposed to kill? Thank you.
What happened back
there? Oh, you know? I can feel something right there. I thought that the ship was between Lina and Mal.
There's something a summoner can do, but it requires tremendous skill. And they will only use it as a last resort.
Is this my life now? Hunted wherever I go.
You could use that little light show and fog that was visible from miles away. Whatever their original mission was, they must have done.
No. You don't want to?
No,
not.
I don't want any of this. Why can't you get rid of it?
If I enter the fold, I'm a beacon for the rock. Oh, I can give you any advice.
You dragged me away from my only friends. You want to know why I've never found someone with this power? Maybe it's because they don't want to be found.
Do you think that there are other people like you?
Were you tested as a child?
I felt it. Really, the sexual tension between you two guys. It's intense. I felt it. Oh, the music. Sorry to repeat it, but they're good.
Why are you back? We were ambushed. Fear of us. We must have been close enough to the fault to have seen the explosion.
Mal? Are you gonna...
Until they decide she's a fraud and put a head on a spike. I'm not wasting time or men on it.
Until a few hours ago, she's running through.
All I know is she's not worth the risk until the king tells me so.
The king?
When I was drafted, my sergeant schooled us in our creature.
Ah, tell us.
Said we would win this war because one of them was worth 50 of us. The few of them with a repeating rifle, and 1 in 10 of our casualties was creature. They said it was unacceptable. How long before they are just as useless as the rest of us?
So, before you were considering Grisha as witch, as monster, now you are using them, still not considering them at all.
I'm bouncing for the clipper. Hey! Was that sawing damage before?
Jasper, I'm gonna look you! I was hesitating between like and love. I can quickly love him.
Of course, would you?
Hello!
No steals in the barrel, huh?
An old friend?
What do you want, Daddy Pants? I need to find someone. This is not a job, isn't it? One that sends you all the way east for a million kruger.
You also heard about it?
Just this evening, yes, you see. She was asking about the conductor as well. Probably about the same job. You warned him. With a note.
That they can follow.
She wanted you to do that so she could have a messenger follow you. Detain, tell me where he is. Right now.
You're clever and really determined, Kaz. I really appreciate that. I appreciate also Inej and Jasper. I can really like you guys.
Finally.
Et on se passe to kill him. Il neige.
The great families flee the war. I smuggled his son some refugees. Yes, please, please.
Naming names. He was 12. And I was 14 when four men took us from our parents' wagon, separated us.
Oh, I didn't get them.
Tell me what I can do to help.
To find him?
The one I deserve to use. Gregor.
Great. I don't run in those circles. You follow the faith, too. What?
You follow the faith?
Ask the saints for.
Don't kill him. We need him.
He's our way to Alina Starkov. He knew. She was using you to sabotage our mission.
Let me choose him over my freedom.
You assume it's one or the other. I have a job for you. Get us to the little palace.
Where are you going?
To get to the Vesta suite.
Am I a prisoner?
Until you and I banish the fog.
You want to train her to be a good Grisha? Why not? For now, I can't see why not. But I think that we're gonna learn stuff about him or about the Grisha, you know, what they're doing to the Grisha. That maybe she's supposed, but me, I'm gonna discover it and I'm gonna hate it. Can already feel it. Allez. Because you're far away from your friends. You're alive, Maddie's alive. If you really want to live, escape, you'll find a way. Mm. Something to hurt people. Nah, Mikael and Dubrov, I have to remember your names. Ah, is it easy? Nah, I don't think so. I think that is brave.
I'm taking her. And when we return, I'll have the buyout to clear the books. This is my collateral.
That much?
The Crow Club.
I knew that you care about him that much. Guys. Okay, I'm gonna continue to ship you, the two of you. Sweet. It's really big. Beginning to work on me. Ooh. I'm sorry. I have some scratches on my hands and also on my arms. That's a long story, so why? That's why I didn't explain it to you in intros, and if you can be interested by that, go check my Twitter. I explained you guys what happened. That was not a funny story, so I'm not gonna explain it right there. I was saying, I'm getting into it, you know? I can feel it, that I'm beginning to involve myself into it. That episode was way easier. I'm searching for the good word. It was lighter, you know, this episode, for informations that we learned into it. For a newbie like me who didn't read the books, that episode was lighter with informations and with references to all of the different places, all of the different, you know, little things and big things about this universe. So it was lighter and easier for me. My mind was not focused like that during all of the episode again, like it was during the first episode. It was sometimes I took some breathes, you know, during it. My mind, I mean, was because that's it. I have the confirmation that we know all of the important characters. I was gonna say I remember some of the names that I missed the first time. Zoya. Yeah, there is a Z, an O, and an A. I'm not sure that I'm putting them at the right place. Zoya. Ah! Yosa, Rosa, Yosa, Zoya. Something like that. The girl with whom Mal flirted. Mikhail and... Ah! Berger. The two friends, you know, that he has. We add new characters, but I think that they're not gonna be important, like we're not gonna keep them for a long time, like Poppy and Eileen. The conductor maybe is gonna be more important because of his story, because of all of this story with Inej. She was helped, conducted at least by him or something like that. She lost a brother, for sure. She has a revenge to take on a guy with a silver tooth. Greggy, she said, something like that. Greggy, something like that. But she has a background just right there. Like Kaz, he has a background with Pekka. He said that if Pekka knew who he was, he would have killed him. He didn't recognize him. And we know that Kaz wants his revenge on Pekka. And that Pekka is a troublemaker, you know, a big issue right there into that city because he's killing people, he's doing bad stuff. And I think that there is something else right there. Kaz, he wants his revenge. When he was a kid, when Kaz was a kid, Pekka killed his parents or someone that he loved. That's why he wants his revenge, something like that. But Pekka killed these persons because there were bad ones for him, you know, like that was threatening him. He has reasons, you know, to kill these persons, and that's why if he would have known right there that Kaz is Kaz, he would have killed him. I'm interested, you know, I'm really interested by Inej's background, by Kaz's background, and you know how I'm reacting with them. I'm feeling that I'm beginning to be involved into that show because I can already like this group. And I can really quick love this group. The three of them, you know, Jesper, Inej and Kaz. Because Kaz is really an interesting character. He's clever. He's really thinking about stuff. As also, I think some feelings for Inej. Even if sometimes he can be maybe impulsive and cold, you know. I know that's the contrary, but I think that you've got what I meant. I think that, yes, he's really an interesting character for that. Inej, same, you know, her background is interesting, her power is interesting, the thing like she's disappearing, she's appearing and all. Her character also, how she is, her attitude, her skills, that can be interesting. And Jesper, I already appreciate his attitude, he's a funny character, but he's also loyal, and you know how much, I mean, you know if you're watching my other reaction videos, you know how much I love, I value loyal characters. That's one of my favorite qualities, so that's why I can really love Quick, Jesper, but also the three of them, this group. I think that they have also a good dynamic because we can see already the relationships between these three. You know, Inej with Kaz, but also Inej with Jesper, Jesper with Kaz. We can already see, define, explain, you know, these three characters and relationships. We have already a lot of things about them, about who they are, about maybe also into their backgrounds, what can be interesting, about what they want, what they can do to get them, but also the relationships between them. For now, I have the impression that they are really well done, you know. I can really be involved into that group really quick. I mean, I can be involved into it. I can involve myself into it really quick. Alina, I'm wondering if she knew or not that she was a sun, the sun summoner. You know, at the end of the last episode, I was wondering if she was a sun summoner or the sun summoner. If it was exceptional, if she was the only one or other ones are existing. Because I understood that there was a prediction about a certain sun summoner who can destroy the fold. But I had the impression that they talked about other Sun Summoners, so maybe I was wrong about that. So she's the Sun Summoner who can save them all, and that's why the general took her to the little palace, so he can teach her how to be a Grisha. The general and her, I felt a sexual tension between them. I think that something right there can happen. I'm not sure that I can ship them because I'm beginning to ship already Mal and Alina. But I can see something, you know, I can see a little tension. You know, the way that they're looking at each other, it's intense. Maybe it's because of the fact that he considers her, you know, as the one who is gonna save them all. And maybe because of the fact that she's a little afraid of him, in a way. I don't know, maybe there is something right there. She, of him or of what he can do to her. That's not the same. You understand what I mean? Of what he can do to her because of the fact that she's the Sun Summoner. What I understood about the Grisha is the fact that before what? I don't know, like a long time ago? No, they said before the general. Like they considered that the Grisha were witches, were monsters, were creatures and all, like it was people that were not considered at all. Then they considered them but to be useful, you know, for the army and stuff. That guy, he said it. But I think that still now Grisha, they are considered not like humans. That's wrong, you know, how they are considering them. Yes, I think that Alina, she knew. She had to know, and that's why she wanted to hide with Mal. Maybe she didn't know that she was that powerful and that she could be the Sun Summoner, but she knew that she had powers. And maybe she didn't want to be considered as a Grisha, to not be far away from Mal, but also to not be treated as a Grisha, because she's already badly treated because of where she's coming from. I understood that, you know, her origins. She's already badly treated because of that, so she was afraid to be even more badly treated because she would have been a Grisha with these origins. You understand what I mean? And right there, she's afraid of what she can do. That's why also she doesn't want this power, because it's also taking her away from our friends and from Mal. Mal wanted to go after her. All of them, you know, I'm thinking Kaz and all this group, they want to go to the little palace for Alina to take her to Drizzen. But Mal, he wants to go to the little palace also for Alina. They all want Alina. That fort was created by a Grisha. I knew that it was magical, and I said that if it was magical, it means that someone created it. For what we saw about his powers, you know, the General Kerrigan, his power, it's to bring darkness with him. It's really the contrary of her powers. She's bringing the light, he's bringing the darkness. I can see, you know, like they can be the nemesis of each other, or they can be the total opposite of each other for a relationship. I can see how it's functioning. For me, you know, the person who created that fort has his powers, the same kind of powers, you know, to create darkness, shadows. Who did it and when and why? And what about the creatures? They're coming from where? I don't know. For now, I don't know. But see, I'm getting more involved into it. I can see it because I can quickly love this group, you know, Inej, Jesper and Kaz. I'm really interested by their characters, their group, their motives, all of their journey and all. I began to ship Mal and Alina, I saw it also. This story, I'm beginning to make theories about it, and I'm beginning to involve myself into it. That episode was lighter on information, and it was easier to be focused. And after the first episode was really rough and also heavy with a lot of information, big ones but also little ones. I think right now, you know, thinking of it again, I think that these little references were there for fans, you know, as wings to tell them, see, we really studied the books, so we can name all of these places, we can name all of this stuff. But was it important and necessary? Now that we have this second episode, and they didn't do that during this second episode at all, they didn't name all of these places again, they didn't make all of these references to little stuff again. So is it really necessary to put all of that in the first episode? I'm thinking about the people like me who are discovering this universe, who didn't read the books. Again, me, I love that. It's not an issue for me. I love that mind game, you know, to remember everything, to be focused and all. But I can think that persons like me who didn't read the books, they maybe don't want to spend an entire episode being totally lost, and maybe they don't want to make that effort to be focused all along. I think that if you didn't read the books, you need to see more than one episode before really having an opinion on that show. And for me, who wants to make reaction videos about it, I think that I'm gonna need more than two episodes, maybe three episodes, to decide if I'm gonna post these reaction videos. Again, you know me, I'm posting reaction videos about a show if I think that my reactions are interesting, but also that my thoughts are interesting enough. For now, I think that my thoughts, I mean, I'm talking a lot during and after the episodes, my reactions, I don't know if I reacted a lot during the episode or not. I think so. I'm not gonna watch the episode 3 right now. I'm gonna do it tomorrow, and I think that if I'm beginning the episode 3, you know, during the intro telling you that I'm excited to be back and that I missed the show, or at least I want to know more about it, I'm excited to learn more about it, it's gonna be a good sign that I'm gonna watch the entire season and I'm gonna post my reaction videos to the entire season. For now, me, I still don't know if I'm gonna post these videos. Again, if I post that on YouTube, it means that I decided that I would post all of the season. I'm less anxious, you know, about what I'm saying. I told you that I was anxious for the fandom of Shadow and Bone to maybe judge me, to maybe not be respectful for the spoilers, but also with my thoughts and reactions as a newbie. I still don't know what you're gonna think about it if I'm posting these videos. I still don't know how you're gonna react, but me, how I'm feeling, you know, after watching this episode and about what I said and all, I'm feeling okay because I said what I wanted to say, you know. I didn't think about it twice. I was not like, or maybe they're not gonna like what I'm gonna say about this character or about this situation. I'm really judging the show, you know, not the books, not the story and all. So I'm less anxious, but I still hope that you're not mad at me for what I said. And I hope also that you appreciate my point of view as someone who didn't read the books, because I think that it's interesting also for fans of the books to see if the show, which maybe worked on them, is working or not on newbies like me. I'm gonna see that, and you're gonna see that. Tell me that on the comments also. But I'm not gonna continue today to watch it. So it's all for you and for me for today. So it's all for me for now. So bye for now. Bye.
Wait a minute, Doc. Are you telling me that you built a time machine?